Alrighty, this video is all about preloading. Don't worry, I can actually show it in my GAC. This guy I'm fighting, auto set. So, this is a perfect opportunity for me to show preloading. So, preloading is still a massive thing in this game. Not everyone knows what it is or how to deal with it properly. So I will show. I intentionally preloaded one team. Preloading is when you go into a fight, like that top one I have up there, and you're unable to kill anyone, and you don't back out. So what that means is when you go back into this fight, they will have turn meter. As if I were to go into this fight, they would not, except Han Solo, because that's his unique. So for instance, I will show you. I will go into this fight, and they will have turn meter. Let's throw a team in that I will... I don't want to win this off the bat, so... So when I go into this fight, I'll try to put it on 1x as fast as I can. Hold on. See, they all have turn meter. They didn't start with 0, they all had turn meter from when the match ended last. And now they all get to go, no matter what my speed is, because they basically had the advantage, they get to go. This can turn a team, this can make it, make or break a fight. Especially when you have to go back and clean it up. So obviously I'm not gonna continue this fight. They're already preloaded, I wanna be able to kill no one. But that's that, that's what preloading is. How to prevent it. There are two good ways to prevent it. Best way is airplane mode. So for me, when I do airplane mode, I'll go down, activate airplane mode. It tells me all this. My Wi-Fi is disabled. Actually, wait, hold on. That's not how you do it. You go into the battle first. Go to battle, because it won't let you go into the battle if your airplane mode's on. So I'm going to do this fight against Watt. Watt lead, whatever, it's fucking an auto set. I'm gonna actually attempt to win this. So, I'm gonna go in. We'll use Jango Fett. Click battle. As it's loading in, right here is when you can go into airplane mode. Turn on airplane mode. Voila. Now we do our fight. We'll see how this goes. I don't know who to kill. So she's a reviver, but she can only... Okay, yeah, I want 3 Baka gone. Now I'll kill her. Actually, probably should have kept her since she was the only one with debuffs in this fight currently. Goodbye! Oh no! Oh, I forgot it comes back. Do-do-do-do! Cool. So as soon as you win it, see how it's told me I'm an error? You take your airplane mode off. Tap try again. Voila, I got my banners. Now, what you can do, so let's say I go back into the Sidious fight. Let's just do, I don't know, TFP lead. Why? Actually, no. We'll have Krennic shine. TFP Death Trooper. So you're attempting to enter this battle that is not full. Okay. As soon as the fight starts, enter airplane mode. Here we go. Alright, so what you do here, since the fight is over, you actually close your application, You can now turn airplane mode off and then re-enter the game. 5-minute video already, okay. All about preloading. I hope this is helpful for anyone in the future, and I hope that it's an easily understandable video about how to avoid preloading teams. Because you don't want preloading, it definitely makes it harder, especially in territory war, where you could preload a team and your other guildmates now have to rely on you to clean, or you have to rely on them to clean up your mess. So now we go back to this team. And the WOT is dead. Oh wait, I couldn't show that preload. That's right, because they were already preloaded. How's that even a good sign? Never mind, hold on. That was not a good one to show because they were already preloaded. Let me do that again. Fuck, I don't know what team that's in. One of these are gonna kill me instantly, so I gotta be fast about this. So Royal Guard, Mace Windu. One Efflux and my team's dead. Maul. First Order, Tarkin. Alright, so once again, go into battle. I'm gonna get ready to hit airplane mode. So I'm in battle. I'll turn on airplane mode now. Need to speed that back up. Oh no! Can I get at least one hit of damage? Please? Well, it's gonna be hard to judge that. So, actually, hold on. Already thinking ahead. Close the application. Turn airplane mode off. Now I should be able to go back in and go into that fight and it not be preloaded. I'm going to actually attempt to beat that team now with one of my GLs. And I should be outspeeding them. If I'm outspeeding them, I should be going first. If they're preloaded, though, they will go first. So that's the team. We have, what would this be? A 555 Jedi Master Luke. I'm actually honestly thinking he might go first. Okay, so I'm going to have to do my JMK against this just to prove a point. So we'll do JMK. We'll send JMK in. I should go first because I did not preload this thanks to airplane mode. See, zero turn meter, I go first. That is the best way to not preload a team. Leave Cam alone! Oh, my high ground buff will be coming soon. I don't know who I'm gonna annihilate. I was hoping that gas would have died by now. Oh, come on, Cam! Almost. Alright, high ground buff. I don't want to switch stances yet. Alright, I think Vader's gonna get annihilated. Alright, time just to beat Jedi Master Luke down. Anyways, that's how you avoid preloading. Is airplane mode. That is one way to avoid it, at the very least. One second. It's actually bothering me a little bit while I'm trying to talk. There we go. So that's how you avoid preloading. You use airplane mode. However, you cannot use airplane mode if you're streaming a battle, because it disconnects you from the internet, so you're not allowed to use airplane mode when you're streaming. It will not show while you're streaming. So, the second way to back out of a fight, it's not the best solution, but it will work if you absolutely have to do it. So, let's go into, let's say, the C team. Let's actually take a team that will do damage even if I drop it. So, let's take EP, Mara, whatever. Empire. Hopefully, I get one turn. Just one turn. So, I can show this. Sith. Alright, whatever. Savage, your time to shine is now. Help me solo this. And I'm going to try to kick or at least damage someone whose protection won't recover. There's no way this fight's going to work out at all. Actually, this is perfect. Vader taking a turn. I can do it. Alright, so we're doing all this. I'm starting to see that my team's going downhill. Doot doot. Shit's not working to my advantage. Could I kill fives? Hold on, I might kill fives here real quick. Oh, I just dropped fives. What is this? Hold on. This would be funny if I actually win this. Oh, damn you, Jango Fett. I have a low geared Mara J. Okay, so right here. This ain't gonna work out for me. I'm gonna lose. I'm gonna die. So what you do, you have to quickly do this before the match is over, or all of your guys die. Sometimes it will not work because you get a bad AoE that kills your whole team at once, and you just don't get a chance to do this, and you just simply close the app. Reopen the app. And luckily this ain't my main account either, so this is perfect to show it off on. Glad my opponent auto-deployed and I remembered to make this video. So I go in. Ah, no, not territory war. Can you just go to the GAC, please? Thank you. I should go back in, and I should be able to see that C. All those guys are still alive, and they will not be preloaded. If I go back into there, none of their turn meter will be at 100% of wherever it was. So that's how you not preload and avoid preloading, because you don't want to end up in this type of situation where if I attempted to beat it with imps, it would be difficult. The best part is just wasting a GL on it, and you don't want to waste a GL on a team like this. Not usually, and it sucks when you do it in territory war, and you're trying to have your guild be as efficient as possible, and shit just does not work out. Because if this was territory war and you still had some walls left over, you would not want to be using this comp. You would want to save this just in case there was GL somewhere else. So, this is the end of this video about preloading. I hope it helps people a bit and learn that it's best to avoid preloading, especially in territory war for your guild. GAC, it helps with GAC as well. If you need to go back in and take a team out or something like that, it helps. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope lessons can be learned.